Now we will discuss about electric field. All of you are familiar with magnetic field. Can you tell me the definition or what is meant by magnetic field? Yes, correct. It is the space surrounding a magnet where its influence can be experienced. So in the same way, we can say what is meant by electric field. So electric field is the space surrounding a charge where its influence can be experienced. So, the space surrounding a charge where its influence can be experienced is known as electric field. And we can define electric field as, well, electric field due to a point charge Q, which is kept at some point in space. How can we define that? We can see the statement. It is defined as the force that a unit positive charge would experience if placed at that point. This, if we are keeping a unit positive charge at some distance from the charge capital Q, and what is the force experienced on that unit positive charge? That is known as electric field. So from this expression or from this statement, we can get the expression of electric field. So we can write electric field as, electric field is equal to limit Q tends to 0 F by Q. This limit Q tends to 0, it is famous. You might have seen, or you might have studied in differentiation. So limit Q tends to 0, what does it mean? It means that Q value is very, very small. The value of Q is very, very small. It approaches to 0 and it will not become 0. If it becomes 0, it has no meaning at all. It will be very, very small. To show that only, we are writing limit Q tends to 0, force experienced on unit charge. That's why we are writing it as F by Q. Here E and F are written in bold letters to show that they are vectors. So in the case of a point charge Q, the electric field, we can write it as electric field is equal to, how can we write electric field? It is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 R square. How is it possible? Force is equal to capital Q into small q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 R square, and E is equal to F by small q. So Q will get cancelled. So we will get the electric field as Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 R square, where Q is the charge of which we want to find the electric field, and R is the distance to the point where we want to find the electric field. So we know, just now we discussed electric field is a vector quantity. Now we should know what is the direction of electric field if the charge is positive and negative. So before discussing that, we'll see what is meant by this plus Q and minus, small letter Q. So this Q, capital letter Q, is nothing but it is known as the source charge. Why it is known as source charge? Because it produces the electric field, and the charge small letter Q is known as test charge because it tests the effect of source charge. So we can say that this test charge should not affect the field of the source charge. So if the value of small q is very, very large, what happens? It may affect the, it will have its own electric field, and because of its own electric field, it may affect the electric field of the charge capital Q or the source charge. That's why we are writing the first expression, we are writing limit Q tends to 0 F by Q, because the value of test charge should be very, very small. And direction of electric field, now we can say if the charge, source charge is positive, electric field will be outward direction. Why? Because the test charge is already, you know that it is positive charge. So force will be repulsive. So electric field of the source charge will be outward direction if the source charge capital Q is positive, and if the point charge is negative, the electric field will be towards the charge. This is very much important. So the direction of electric field, if the point charges are positive or negative, how we can say, if the point charge Q is positive, direction of electric field will be outward direction, and if the point charge is negative, the direction of electric field will be towards that charge. Now we'll see what's the unit of electric field. From that expression, E is equal to F by Q. Can you say what is SI unit of electric field? Yes, we'll start with the SI unit of force. What's SI unit of force? Very good. SI unit of force is Newton and SI unit of charge is Coulomb. So we can say SI unit of electric field is equal to Newton per Coulomb, and which is nothing but we can write it as capital letter N by C. And there is one more unit of electric field, and that unit is known as volt per meter. We will write it as capital V by M. And this unit, we will discuss it in detail in the next chapter, where we will study about electric potential. So presently, you have to remember only one unit of electric field, that is the unit of electric field is Newton per Coulomb. It's a unit of electric field is Newton per Coulomb. Now we will see what's the dimension. Already we have discussed in 11th standard dimension. So dimension of force divided by dimension of charge will be equal to the dimension of electric field. Dimension of force is given by MLT raised to minus 2. Dimension of charge is 80 because current is equal to charge into time. Sorry, current is equal to charge by time, or charge is equal to current into time. So from this we can write it as MLT raised to minus 3 into A, that is the dimension of electric field. So whenever you are solving problems based on electric field, two things you have to keep it in mind. You have to find the magnitude of the electric field, then you have to see the direction, and finally after writing the result you have to write the unit. Now we'll see what's the expression of electric field due to multiple charges. So if many charges are there, Q1, Q2, Q3, etc. are at different positions, and R1, R2, R3, etc. Rn are the distances to the point where we want to find the electric field. So total electric field, we can write it as same by superposition principle. Total electric field can be written as E1 plus E2 plus E3 etc. plus En. So here all are written in bold letters to show that they are vectors. We are not representing by arrow. So electric field can be written as KQ1 by R1 square plus etc. plus KQn by Rn square into unit vector Rn cap. And here K is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. That can be taken common. So we will get the expression total electric field as K into sigma I is equal to 1 to n q by rp square into unit vector rp. So here whenever we are finding electric field due to multiple charges, we have to find the electric field due to each charge, and we have to find the total electric field. Magnitude should be added and direction accordingly you have to find it. Now we'll discuss one problem based on electric field. So a tiny ball, its mass is given 0.012 kilogram and carries a charge of minus 18 microcoulomb. And what electric field is needed to cause the ball to float above the ground? You have to find about the magnitude and direction of the electric field. So, when then, no doubt, if you are keeping an object above the ground, you know that that object will come to the ground because of gravity. So, that object should remain or float in air if and only if the gravity should be equal to the force due to electric field, or in other words we can say the net force acting on that object should be zero. So we can write mg is equal to qe. How qe comes? Because if e is equal to f by q, from that we can write f is equal to q into e. So mg should be equal to qe, and you can, from this you can write E is equal to mg by q. M is given, g is given. You can substitute those values. So you will get the expression of electric field as 6.5 into 10 raised to minus 3. Unit is given by Newton per Coulomb. Now, can you tell me what's the direction? You might have thought that direction will be upward direction. Is it possible? No, because the direction of force, force due to that electric field will be upward direction. But the direction of electric field will be downward direction, because the charge is negative. Then only it will become, the force will become upward direction. So direction of electric field will be downward direction, and the force on that charge due to that electric field will be upward direction, which can cancel the weight of that object, which will result in the net force to be zero. So from this you can find the value of E. E is equal to 6.5 into 10 raised minus 3 Newton per coulomb. Now we will discuss another question. So two charges are placed on the x-axis. One charge, its magnitude is given, and another charge also magnitude given. Separation, it is at a distance of 3 cm and 9 cm. And find the electric field at 6 cm, and you have to find both magnitude and direction. So before solving the problem, first we can try to draw the diagram of that problem. So two charges are there. One is at it is kept at 3 cm, Q1 is equal to 8.5 microcoulomb, and another charge is at 9 cm, its value is given by minus 21 microcoulomb. Where we have to find the electric field? We have to find the electric field at 6 cm. Now we can see what's the direction. First of all, we can see what's the direction of electric field. So due to this positive charge, the electric field will be outward direction. So we can represent the electric field due to Q1 as E1, which is in outward direction. And what's the direction of E2? So the direction of E2 will be towards that negative charge. So we can see that from the diagram, we can see that both the electric fields are in the same direction. So it's very easy to find the net electric field. So we can write net electric field E is equal to E1 plus E2. Here E1, E2, everything it is represented in bold letters to show that they are vectors. We are not using arrows. Actually, we can use arrows or bold letters to show them vectors. And E can be written as Q1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 R1 square plus Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 R2 square. Q1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 R1 square is the electric field due to first charge Q1, and Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 R2 square is the electric field due to second charge. And you can substitute the value of Q1, R1, etc. And 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 can be taken common. So Q1 by R1 square plus Q2 by R2 square. Value of Q1 is 8.5 into 10 raised to minus 6, and R1 is 3 into 10 raised to minus 2 whole square, plus Q2 is 21 into 10 raised to minus 6 by R2 is 3 into 10 raised to minus 2 whole square. 9 into 10 raised to 9, 3 into 10 raised to minus whole square can be written as 9 into 10 raised to minus 4, and 8.5 plus 21 can be written as 29.5 into 10 raised to minus 6. What you will get? You will get the answer as 29.5 into 10 raised to 7 Newton per coulomb. So this is the magnitude of the electric field. Now what's the direction? The direction of the electric field, we can write it as towards right or towards the negative charge. So whenever we are solving problems based on electric field due to multiple charges, some things we have to keep it in mind. First of all, we have to represent, if possible, we can represent that problem by diagram, and we can represent the direction of electric field due to individual charges. Then we have to apply parallelogram law of vector addition, or we can resolve those electric field into components, and we can find the net electric field. So this is the method how we can solve the problems based on electric field due to multiple charges. Similar problems are there. You can try and you can solve.